After unpicking the old dress, I've taken out the darts and I've pressed it flat. This is the back of the dress, this is the front of the dress, and that's one of the sleeves. Now, there were a few, if you remember, there were a few mistakes that I wanted to rectify in this before I actually go on to using this as a template for my next one. In my case, I need to trim this down a little bit. If it's something that you've put on weight and something's gone tighter, then most likely the fitting above here would still remain the same, but around here you would want it a little bit wider on the bust area, curved a little bit out, and then wider on the hips going down. So where I was pointing, this is where you'd be extending it. In my case, I'm going to retake my measurements, just a couple of measurements, the hip measurement, and also around here I wanted to trim this down a little bit. Now around the armhole it was slightly just gathering around this area. So that's the couple of modifications that I'm going to make on this template. The difference on the sleeve was that it was a lot shorter and it was slightly wider there. I would probably leave the sleeve the same width from here, but when I actually go on to seaming it, I would seam it a little bit deeper and then also extend it at the bottom. The length of the dress, obviously, because I want them longer, I can just go on to extend these a little bit longer. Now what I've done with these, both of the pieces, is I've actually pressed them and then I have ironed them in half. So I've centered it and just halved it and ironed it. And that's basically what you would be doing. So the couple of modifications that we're going to do on here is, I'm just going to take my hip measurements, which is 40, and which if I look on this, this requires on the hips I have got about an inch extra. So what I can do with this is I can use this as my template and leave it exactly the same, and that extra inch that's been left over, now I can use that as my seaming allowance. So that I will cut exactly the same as this, but I will use that as my seam allowance. The only differences that I will make on here is I'm going to slightly take off a slight bit of the excess on the back of the shoulder. If you remember, I actually cut into this, and I will also trim it down from the neckline and take this in a little bit deeper. So what this has done is brought my shoulder shape slightly up, and also I'm going to take the waistline a little bit down, because now that I've lost weight, my waist is more apparent, and on the hips I'm going to leave it the same. So basically what I've done is I've taken the whole of the neck cutting sort of slightly down, and to lengthen it I would extend the length further down. So now before my opening on my sides fell over here, this would fall a lot lower down. So if you measure it about 14 inches from the top, it would actually fall to about over here. So that measurement before, it was up here, now it's gone down there. And that's the back of the dress. Now I've just taken off, if you can see, these are the pieces that I've taken off to make it smaller. On the front is exactly the same thing that is going to happen on the waistline. The neckline, I wouldn't request you to do anything. Don't bother cutting the neckline. We are going to take it about half an inch off the top of the shoulder. And then this, I'm going to curve it in and take off a slightly deeper cut on around the armhole. I'm still keeping the existing opening at the bottom. I've just taken it in deeper around the armhole area over here. I've also left it exactly the same on the top of the shoulder, because if you remember, the top of the shoulder was perfectly fine. Now, since I've taken off this piece from here, the whole of the dress has sort of come up. So my opening split would fall a lot lower, my hip line would fall a lot lower. Now, in order to address that, I need to, if I measure where my hip line falls from the top to, my hip line falls at about 20 inches. So from the top, 20 inches is where I would actually go about having the split. And it's 20 inches, 10 inches across this way. So that sort of falls around about here. Now, my measurement for my waistline will also would have dropped because of taking that excess off. So now the thinnest part actually falls around here before it was here. So I'm just going to slightly take that down so that my waistline measurement seems a lot lower as well. Now I will need a slight bit of a seam allowance on this one, whereas and that sort of is the difference that is going to happen from this dress to my new dress. The sleeves, like I said, they've already been cut fairly deep. If I open this up and show you what that sleeve cut looks like, it's sort of maybe that way. That's the shape of the sleeve. This is the front and that's the back. I'm going to slightly take about half an inch off from the front because I want a more defined look. It's a thicker fabric that I'm using, and because of that, now that is a lot deeper at the back, a lot deeper cut at the front, a lot wider on the back, and I've just slightly shaped it. The width of the sleeve I will leave the same, but the length over here I will extend another maybe 3 inches. So that's all the amendments done on the existing dress pattern, and we're going to use the same template now to cut out a new outfit.